And you think about the story of St. Patrick, you know, this fellow who was a slave, you know, that the Romans had enslaved. He somehow managed to escape, make his way to Ireland, and then became a priest, then eventually a bishop. And in that time, you know, in the 3rd, 4th century, Ireland converted to Catholicism without shedding any blood, which was, if not unprecedented, certainly unusual. And a lot of that is attributed to St. Patrick. When he became Christian, clearly he had he was recognized for his strength of preaching, his ability to lead, thus was ordained a bishop. So again, this is toward the beginning, the earlier part of the church, in which it was still coming to a sense of who it was. And recognizing, well, clearly at the beginning of the church that we were a missionary church. So when Patrick then returned home, determined that he was never going to leave, that's when, you know, he planted his roots deeply and thus became really one of the great leaders of the church in that particular period of time in that particular part of the world. So I think that's part of the attraction to St. Patrick, the fact that, well, as tradition has it, he also rid Ireland of all snakes. But that, you know, it speaks of a kind of grit, kind of resilience that marks the Irish people, certainly in their own minds, perhaps in the minds of other folks as well, that this is a people, much like St. Patrick, you know, who, you know, got knocked down quite a bit, managed to get up every single time.